Tim Reese back on the VolState Sports Network, where we move to game two after Pioneers take game one of the doubleheader and second game of the series, 7-6. Come from behind victory as Pioneers scored seven runs in the fifth and the sixth to eke out a victory over the Dyersburg State Eagles. Jack McLaurie got his third win in three decisions. David Edwards takes the loss. He falls to 0-2. And Noah Eatman picks up his first save. Ball State moves to 3-10 in conference play, 13-17 overall. Dyersburg State falls to 15-17 and 5-9. You see Braxton Alexander hauling off the hose that assistant coach Shane Kemp just used to water down the field. 76 degrees here. Well, now it's moved to 78. Feels like a 79. Beautiful sunshine, wind coming in out of, that's the northwest. Showing on my weather app is coming out of the southwest, but it's blowing from center field to the right field line as the Pioneers take the field. Let's get to the Toyota of Gallatin starting lineups. First for the visiting Eagles, Edward Mateo leading off. He's going to be the DH again. Kobe Benson at shortstop. Batting second, Enrique Alvarez Jr., the first baseman, batting third. Parker Patterson back behind the plate. He's hitting cleanup. Carlos Garcia back out in right field, batting fifth. Jake Santos at third base. Batting sixth, and Amir Streeter. Batting seventh, playing center field again, Matthew Vargas at second base, batting eighth. And Jack Clark getting his first start in right field, batting ninth and on the mound for the Eagles, Jacob Sitton, right-hander out of Bradford, Tennessee. Two Bradford, Tennessee pitchers on the mound for Dyersburg State today. He's a transfer from Christian Brothers, but he played at Milan High School. That's the school made famous by Big John Carter. Red-shirting first baseman here at Ball State, as well as Shelby Green, freshman softball player, Lady Pioneer. On the mound for the Pioneers, Caden Trigg will get the start here in game two of the doubleheader. Trigg gets his third start of the year. It's in his fourth appearance. We are set to go here in the top of the first. First pitch swinging is Mateo over in the right field. Stephen Bell will make the catch as we get started. 2:54 p.m. Central Time. Accurate Mortgage providing us the accurate temperature at 78 degrees. Feels like 79. Thanks to Mike Hoover over at Accurate Mortgage for their support of Ball State Baseball. Trigg pouring in strikes here. Gets a foul ball just over the Pioneer dugout. Benson was 0-for-2 in game one, walked twice, scored a run. Trigg tries to get that high fastball. It's a little bit too high. Christian Dunn behind the plate catching the young right-hander. Another foul ball gets over the backstop screen. Trigg's 5'10", 155-pound freshman from Murfreesboro, Tennessee, attended Rockvale High School. He and Nathan Aguilar, teammates. Aguilar started at third base in yesterday's game one, but injured his shoulder. Benson stays alive with Enrique Alvarez Jr. on deck. Another tapper foul, and that gets off a lower body part of Kobe Benson. Count remains one ball, two strikes. Just getting started here in the top of the first inning in game number two of the doubleheader. Pioneers trying to get the sweep over Dyersburg State. Swing and a miss. Trigg gets him on strikes. Enrique Alvarez Jr. steps in. 0-for-3 in game one. Walking a strikeout. He's not 0 for the day now. Gets a base hit up the middle. Two out single. I believe that's his first hit of the series. It is. Patterson 0-for-2 in game one of the doubleheader. Steps in there with two outs. Breaking pitch misses down. Luis Maldonado is our home plate umpire. And Christian Moffitt working the bases. Swing and a miss. Trigg comes in with an even 7.0 ERA. Nine innings of work, giving up nine hits, eight runs, seven earned, seven walks, six strikeouts, and back-to-back hits with two outs for the Eagles. That's Patterson's first hit of the series. Carlos Garcia stands in. Breaking pitch missed somewhere. Garcia was 1-for-2. Game one of the doubleheader, did not play in game one of the series. A little bit up. Trigg now two balls and no strikes. His parents are Mike and Karen Trigg. Two-oh pitch. That missed somewhere again. Not sure if that's high or inside there. You get a new home plate umpire, you get a whole new strike zone. That one gets in there, 3-0. Strike call. Trigg a little delayed getting his collegiate career started. Some injury he was working through. There's a 3-1 foul ball, and the count goes full. Full Count Ministries, full count. We'll have another Full Count Ministries verse after this game. Stay with the Easter theme. In the book of Mark. Three-two pitch, runner goes, runners go. Flying out to center field. Guess who loses his lid again? Reggie Cooper, but he makes the catch. It is the third out, so Trigg able to work around two out singles to retire the Eagles here in the top of the first. Two runners left on base. Head to the bottom of the first. Let's go ahead and get you the Toyota of Gallatin starting lineup for batting lineup for VolState. Leading off, Logan Molnar playing shortstop. Zach Zimmerle playing left field. He'll bat second. Stephen Bell in right field hitting third. The DH, Cannon Lewis, in the cleanup spot. at first base. Connor Paul, he'll bat fifth. Christian Dunn behind the plate hitting sixth. Reggie Cooper just made that last out. Batting seventh, playing center field, Brady Knepper at second base hitting eighth. And Walker Strange back at third base batting ninth off of Jacob Sitton. Sitton transfer from Christian Brothers University. On for his 10th appearance of the year. His ninth start. Make sure I have that correct. I do. Comes in with a 5.57 ERA. 42 innings of work, 44 hits, 38 runs, 26 are earned. Has walked 30, struck out 51 coming into today. That was tied for fourth in the conference. Giving up two home runs, five hit batters. As Dyersburg State has used the same three starting pitchers for all four, now five of the series. Ben Barisco, Cole Cates, and now Jacob Sitton. Cates went five innings, six hits, four runs in the first game, the doubleheader, walked one, struck out two, did not figure into the decision. Ben Barisco did take the loss in yesterday's game. His starting pitcher went only one and a third. He gave up six runs, five were earned, three walks and a strikeout. He fell to 2-3. Caleb Pika got his first win of the year in seven decisions yesterday. He's 1-6. Jack McLaurie goes to 3-0 after the win come from behind victory. And Noah Eatman with his first save of the year. Logan Molnar leads off against the right-hander Jacob Sitton. Sitton, 6 foot, 230-pound sophomore. Facing a sophomore shortstop. First pitch is high, ball one. Lifts one out to left center field. Over is Jack Clark, but the center fielder, Amir Streeter, makes the catch. And Zimmery steps to the plate. Zach Zimmerly. His dad sitting right in front of the press box. Jody, an alumni of VolState. Zimmerly 0-3 in game one of the doubleheader. Fastball backs him off the plate. Did walk and score. Had a stolen base. So on the high and deep out to left center field, sends Amir Streeter back, but he will catch it right in front of the Dudek communication sign for out number two. Zimmerly put a charge in that one, vying for his first home run of the year. Two flyouts to Streeter in center. Bring Bell to the plate with nobody on and two out. Bell was 1-3. Big RBI in the fifth. On a single up the middle. There's a breaking pitch. It gets in there on the outside corner. Bell, one hit for the series so far, but on base and very productive in yesterday's game one. Walked twice, hit twice, drove in two runs. Tries to go the opposite way there and fouls that one off. Two-two pitch is high. Full count ministries, full count to the right fielder for the Pioneers with Cannon Lewis standing on deck. Ground ball to second. Vargas up. And a throw to Enrique Alvarez Jr. is in time. A 1-2-3 inning for Jacob Sitton. No score through one. You're listening to the VolState Sports Network.
We're all working in the cloud. But what really is the cloud? If you start pulling back the clouds themselves, you find out it's an infrastructure. Computer science is really computer engineering. Right now,
Middle Tennessee is quickly becoming a growing tech hub with several IT companies that are looking for skilled workers.
If you're pursuing the CIT program at Ball State, you're preparing yourself to fill those positions.
Have you ever wondered what happens when you click buy it now? A whole series of transactions take place from the manufacturer to your front door.
That is logistics and supply chain management.
At VolState, we offer end-to-end supply chain courses.
Going into the future, our students need to understand these processes.
A lot of business is dependent upon getting a product on time.
Students here at VolState are able to leave here with that knowledge.
Because the supply chain
is counting on me.
Moves to the top of the second, no score. Dyersburg State to send 6, 7, and 8 to the plate. To face Caden Trigg, the young freshman right-hander out of Rockvale High School, just outside of Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Murfreesboro, if you're not interested, if you're not interested, turn it off. But if you're not from the area, Murfreesboro is located about 45 minutes east of Nashville. Jake Santos steps in. First pitch he sees is high and outside. Santos 1-for-2 in game one of the doubleheader. Ahead in the count now. 2 balls, no strikes. Walked twice, also struck out. There's one in there at the knees, first called strike. Santos, like a lot of these Eagles, is from Southern Florida. He's down there in Miami. J.C. Menendez territory. Trigg, 3 balls and a strike now to Santos. Delivers called strike on the outside corner. Another full count. Ministries, full count. Working quickly is Trigg, and he delivers pitch in there that Stephen Bell will come in and catch. That ball just hung up in the air.
Number 13, Amir Streeter.
Here's the first out. Just as in the first inning, Bell makes the first put out of the inning on the leadoff batter, and Amir Streeter will step to the plate. He had 2 hits in game one. Reached base 3 times. Also had a walk. Drove in 2 runs, one with a walk and one with a single. Breaking pitch, must have missed down. Hot dog wrapper flying through the air. Not sure if that got on the broadcast or not. That's a deep fly ball to left field. Back goes Zimmerle. He is looking up, and that ball will hit over the fence. Looks like it must have hit the curb out there because it came back toward the field, but Streeter picks up a solo home run. Give the Eagles the early lead as they did in game one.
Stepping to the plate, number 24, Matthew Varga.
This is Amir Streeter's second home run of the year. With the wind blowing in, Vargas looks at ball one. Trigg has fallen behind again. Three balls, no strikes. No idea where that pitch was. Trigg's looking in like, okay, the other three maybe I understand, but Christian Dunn now turns around to talk to the umpire.
That, number 22. Jake
find out Walker. What happened. I guess. First walk of the game by Trigg brings Jack Clark to the plate. His first plate appearance. That is five straight outside the strike zone for Trigg. Clark from Miami Shores, Florida. Dyersburg State has the pipeline. Popped up into center field. Cooper moves over into the alley, and the wind pushed that one over there. Makes the catch for out number two.
Number 26, Edward Mateo.
Now two outs. Brings up Mateo, who flew out to Bell in the first. Trigg gets ahead of Mateo here with a called strike. Amir Streeter with a solo home run to left field. Gives Dyersburg State the lead 1-0. And a parachute breaking pitch catches that outside corner. Now ahead 0-2. Mateo, who's a switch hitter, as well as Kobe Benson, who's on deck. About 25 feet away from the batter. Another pop-up. This is over toward the Pioneers dugout, and Walker Strange is going to have the wind blow that one around. He thought that was a lot closer to the dugout than it was, and it falls harmlessly to the ground, and Mateo's going to get another opportunity to hit. Almost like the pop-up that ended game one. A lot closer to third base. Slow roller to the right side. Connor Paul Gloves going to flip to Trigg, who makes the catch on the run and steps on first base for out number three. So the PFP works. 3-1 on the putout. But Dyersburg State with a long ball grabs the lead. 1-0 as we head to the bottom of the second inning. Be right back on the VolState Sports Network.
I took business management because I want to have my own business one day.
It was time for me to take that step and enroll in VolState.
When a student comes to VolState, they can leave here with knowledge that applies to all aspects of business.
Cybercrimes take place online, and companies need more well-trained workers to stop it.
VolState is training me to help combat cybercrimes in the future.
We're training them for those type of jobs that are out there. VolState CIT programs prepare students to earn industry standard certifications within the IT industry.
I choose VolState because the future needs me now. My story could be your story.
Head to the bottom of the second inning. Jacob Sitton comes out now with a 1-0 lead. Face 4, 5, and 6 in the VolState lineup. Upper 70s here in Middle Tennessee. Appreciate you all coming back for game two of the doubleheader. Pioneers trying to get the sweep, but they're going to have to come from behind. Take a hack. Cannon Lewis on the first pitch you see. Comes up empty on probably a two-seam fastball that moved away from Lewis as it got to the plate. Breaking pitch apparently stayed up a little too high. Lewis 0-for-3 in game one, and gets that one off of the, must have been the handle of the bat, and had some English on it over to Vargas. Vargas about overran that ground ball, but recovers and makes the catch, throws over to first base for out number one. He's made the last two plays. Connor Paul was 2 for 3 in game one. Steps in, scored a run. Heard from Mam is. Probably listening in Tulsa. A little late on that fastball. Count goes 1-1. Fastball outside, and there's the double clutch from Parker Patterson. The international sign of, I think he might have missed one there. He might have caught that a little bit too quickly, and say you might want to stick it. Caught it like that right there where he knew that pitch wasn't going to be called a ball. Good-looking catcher back there, Parker Patterson. Not sure if he's committed to go somewhere already or not, but there is ball four. The first base runner for VolState here in the 31st game of the year for the Pioneers. Christian Dunn gets his first at-bat of the series. Steps in from Collierville, Tennessee. Transfer from right here in Dyersburg. Was there this past fall. Probably caught Jacob sitting in the fall, swings and misses at the first pitch he sees. Played his first year of college at Blinn Junior College down in Texas. 6 foot, 195 pound sophomore. Played at Collierville High School. Swings and misses at another fastball. Son of Cordell and Baisha Dunn. Shannon, Shalina, Nia, CJ, Colin, and Bailey are his siblings. He's got a grandma in Tunica, Mississippi, and he swings and misses at a breaking pitch. He's down on strikes. First strikeout for Sitton. Also has a granddad and a grandma in Greenville, Mississippi. Reggie Cooper, co-Toyota of Gallatin player of the game in game one. Was 2 for 3, takes a hack right there and comes up empty. 2 for 3, had a double, drove in a run, and scored the 7th run of the game. A hustle play, fastball whispers at the inside corner. Down in the count, 0-2. He was on third base. A wild pitch that got away from Parker Patterson and just slid underneath the tag. So he threw back to the pitcher. There's a line drive in the left field. That'll get down for a base hit. Third hit of the afternoon for Reggie Cooper. Puts runners at first and second with two out. Nipper steps at a plate. Four batters in the VolState lineup, these 5, 6, 7, and 8 hitters in the previous game all went 2 for 3. Connor Paul, Lex Falsoni, Reggie Cooper, and this young man, Brady Nepper. Standing, he's got a wide open right side. Let's see if he tries to shoot one through there. First pitch to breaking pitch inside. So the first hit of the game for VolState belongs to Reggie Cooper. Fastball gets in there for a strike. On deck, Walker Strange. There's another strike called. Nepper didn't look like he was expecting those last two fastballs. They were right down Broadway and didn't offer it either one. I got a 1-2 count. Chopper to short. Benson's going to go the short way to Vargas at second base. And that will end the inning. We'll take a break. We'll be right back on the VolState Sports Network.
We're all working in the cloud. But what really is the cloud? If you start pulling back the clouds themselves, you find out it's an infrastructure. Computer science is really computer engineering. Right now,
Middle Tennessee is quickly becoming a growing tech hub with several IT companies that are looking for skilled workers.
If you're pursuing the CIT program at Ball State, you're preparing yourself to fill those positions.
Have you ever wondered what happens when you click buy it now? A whole series of transactions take place from the manufacturer to your front door.
That is logistics and supply chain management.
At VolState, we offer end-to-end supply chain courses.
Going into the future, our students need to understand these processes.
A lot of business is dependent upon getting a product on time.
Students here at VolState are able to leave here with that knowledge.
Because the supply chain
is counting on me.
Top of the third we go. 2, 3, and 4 to face Caden Trigg here in the top of the third. Kobe Benson. Move out of the way slightly of that breaking pitch. Struck out in the first, gave Caden Trigg quite a battle, fouling off a number of pitches, and then eventually swung and missed it. Pitch a little bit high and out. He gets a solid base hit in the right field here, leading off the third. Benson's first hit of the day. Went 2-for-4 in yesterday's game. Two RBIs and a run scored. Enrique Alvarez Jr. steps in. It's the fourth hit. Throw over to first base. Moves Benson back. Another throw over. Connor Paul just about pushed Benson off the base. He was a little bit out of sorts over there. Benson a little bit quick getting to the base, but a little shorter lead does not go. First pitch is low and outside. Benson had a stolen base in game one of the doubleheader. Had two in yesterday's game. Does not go here. Swinging a foul ball. He gets over the head of Tyler Brown and standing just outside of the Eagle dugout. Alvarez Jr. has a wide open right side of the infield. Throw over. Brady Nepper playing a double play depth. Solo home run by Amir Streeter. The difference in the game, Benson does not go, pitches down. Zach Zimmerly in left, Reggie Cooper in center, Stephen Bell in right. It's the same as game one of the doubleheader and yesterday's game as well. Swing and a miss on a slow breaker. Walker Strange is at third, Logan Molnar at short, Brady Nepper at second, and Connor Paul at first base. Alvarez backs away from that. We'll have a full count. Ministries full count to the Eagles first baseman from Miami, Florida. 6'4", 210 pounds. He's a sophomore. Runner goes. Pitch is swung on and missed. Throw down to second base. Not in time. So the attempt at the do that double play, strike him out, throw him out. Comes up one out short. Fourth stolen base of the series for Kobe Benson. Second strikeout for Trigg. Parker Patterson has Caden Trigg throwing that ball to Brady Knepper. Almost looked like it was going into center field. Trigg threw a changeup over to Knepper, who was not even covering the base. So apparently they don't count that as a disengagement. They counted it as a pickoff attempt. Patterson fouls that one straight back. Parker singled to left in his first at-bat of the game. Had an RBI on a sac fly in game one. Fouls that one off. He's down in the count 0-2. Lady Pioneers lost game one of the doubleheader. It wasn't close. Lost 11-4. Go on Game Changer if you're so inclined and watch that. Chattanooga State's got a 3-1 lead in the top of the third in game two. So Lady Pioneers in danger of losing 3 out of 4 to Chatt State at home. Came in as the number 20 team in the country and JUCO Division I softball. Pioneers will move or have an away game series. As there's a line drive at Brady Knepper. Makes the catch, but Benson is back to second base. Another chance at a doodat double play averted by the Eagles. Baseball team will travel to Morristown, Tennessee next weekend. Friday and Saturday, as it's scheduled right now, to take on the number 14 team in the country, who just won 2 out of 3 against Southwest Tennessee. Walter State. Carlos Garcia is at ball one, 2 outs and a runner at second. He flew out to center field to end the first. Trigg lost that breaking pitch up high. Have another Allie Cassidy Brickenstone alumni spotlight a little bit later on in the ball game. Got an email from Noah Eatman's grandmother. So strike called. Inquiring about the brick for Noah. Debbie Brogdon, Gigi, as Noah calls her. Swing and a miss. Gigi's down there in Parrish, Florida, near the Tampa-Bradenton area. Fouled off. My older brother's has a place down there in Palmetto. About 45 minutes away from there, another brother has a place in Venice, Florida. You just can't hide money, Debbie. You know what I'm saying? Got places in greater Cincinnati areas. Trigg gets the swing and a miss to retire Garcia. He strikes out 2 in the inning. Strands the leadoff single. And keep the deficit 2-1 run. We head to the bottom of the third. It took several innings for the Pioneers to get on the board in game one. But they scored 7 late in the ballgame to take the second game of the series. They are 2-0 against the Dyersburg State Eagles. I'd like to thank some more sponsors. Wilson Bank and Trust, Tommy Decker, another former player for Jim McGuire over at MTSU. He's a loan officer with Wilson Bank and Trust in Hendersonville. They have locations throughout Middle Tennessee. He's located at one of the Hendersonville locations. They're based out of Lebanon. They've got a sign out there just below the VolState Toyota of Gallatin scoreboard out there in left center field, as does Accurate Mortgage. The Curbing Edge, Jersey Mike's, Summit Concrete, Dew Deck Communications, and MGM Industries with outfield signs. If you're interested in it, getting your business advertising on the outfield sign here at Pioneer Field, send me an email at treesports@gmail.com, and I'll get you in touch with the folks that can make that happen. Very, very, actually, a small donation to the athletic program is what it takes. So, probably not going to be a big hit to your budget if you have a successful business. Bottom of the third we go. Walker Strange steps in, fouls the first pitch off. Fastball just above the letters from Jacob Sitton out for his third inning of work. Strange 0 for 1 in game 1 of the doubleheader. Walked and had an RBI and a sac fly. That one missed somewhere. I'm not sure where. The count goes 3-3. Ground ball to the left side. That will sneak through into left field for a leadoff hit. Strange picks up his first hit in a while. I think his last hit was down in Roan. Love to see Walker Strange start to get hot. It's two hits now for the Pioneers. Logan Molnar steps in. He's looking for his first hit of the day. There's a strike called on the fastball. Molnar flew out to lead off the bottom of the first. Sitton went four innings in the loss to Southwest Tennessee. There's a ground ball, could be two. Vargas dribbles it over to Kobe Benson, couldn't get it out of his glove. Walker Strange went back to second base just in case they didn't get him out, but Molnar will ground out, or ground into a fielder's choice, and he will replace Strange at first base. Zach Zimmerle steps to the plate. Zim also flew out to center field, started to go. They're going to say he went on the swing. Looked like a pretty good pitch. I'll stay with nine hits in game one of the doubleheader. Throw over to first. Molnar's back. Molnar with 10 stolen bases. Leads the club. Fastball in the outside corner for strike two. Zimmerle, a redshirt freshman, came here as a shortstop from Hendersonville High School and has worked his way into the starting lineup in the outfield. Has played all three of the outfield spots this year. Press box has four people in it. Three of them are left-handed pitchers. I aren't one of them. 1-2 pitch, breaking pitch, popped up in just into the outfield grass. Kobe Benson's going to make that catch. Yesterday's starting pitcher and game winner, Kayla Pika, in the press box. Parker White, sophomore left-hander. To my right, he's helping Braxton Alexander apparently pick songs out. Stephen Bell steps to the plate. Actually, he's playing police officer. He's running radar just for the fun of it. Practicing to become a Tennessee Highway Patrolman. Pulled his gun out of his holster like he's going to get somebody at gunpoint here. 2-0 pitch. That's going to hit Stephen Bell. Where did that get him? Might have got him in the front area. He get hit. Well, he's acting like that left leg right there is injured. Doesn't want to put any weight on it. His all-world trainer, Justin McKinney, worked his way out of the Lady Pioneers dugout across campus and apparently switched places with athletic director Bobby Hudson, who was working the concession stand down below the press box here. We're on the second floor and not sure where that got him. Maybe the upper left thigh, I'm thinking. Maybe the knee, just kind of flexing that knee like maybe it got him there. He's going to take his third hit by pitch in the series and hobble down to first base with two outs. Two on, and Cannon Lewis looking to bust free today. Four RBIs in yesterday's ball game. Looking for his first of the day here, and right now would be a great time. Two outs, two on. High fastball, not looking good for Lewis there. Cannon from Beach High School just down the road. He's from Hendersonville. Redshirt sophomore transfer from Roan State Community College. Son of Ryan and Daphne Lewis. Swing and a miss at the 2-0 fastball. 6 foot, 215 pound, business management major here. Hello to Grandpa and Grandma in Hendersonville, and Papa and Granny also in Hendersonville. Just got under that breaking pitch, fouls it back. Connor Paul hoping to get an at-bat here in the third. Pioneers down 1-0 on the solo home run by Amir Streeter, center fielder for Dyersburg. 2-2 pitch coming from Sitton. Another foul ball off to the right side. Wind will aid that one and get into the aluminum seats between the dugout and the Bobby Hudson Pavilion. Bobby Hudson, longtime athletic director here at VolState. Been here, I think, 39 years. He is 53 years old. Just kidding. Popped up. That should be playable out in right field for Carlos Garcia. And he will make the catch. Looked a little iffy, but it got in the glove. No runs, one hit. No errors, two runners left on base. We are through three, scheduled for seven. 1-0, Dyersburg leads.
I took business management because I want to have my own business one day.
It was time for me to take that step and enroll in VolState.
When a student comes to VolState, they can leave here with knowledge that applies to all aspects of business.
Cybercrimes take place online, and companies need more well-trained workers to stop it.
VolState is training me to help combat cybercrimes in the future.
We're training them for those type of jobs that are out there. VolState CIT programs prepare students to earn industry standard certifications within the IT industry.
I choose VolState because the future needs me now. My story could be your story.
A degree in criminal justice can help you find the exciting career that you've been looking for. As a member of law enforcement, as a crime scene investigator, a teacher in a classroom, a detective working on cases, a lawyer or judge, or nearly any job where you get to put the bad guys away. Learn more at volstate.edu.
Tim Reese back on the VolState Sports Network. We move to the top of the fourth inning. Caden Trigg, right-handed starter for VolState, will face 6, 7, and 8. First pitch to Jake Santos, breaking pitch high. Santos led off the second inning. Flew out to Stephen Bell in right field. Triggs missed with the first three that he's delivered to Santos. Comes back with a strike. And walks the second batter. Not what you want to start an inning, a leadoff walk. They walked 10 batters. It looks like that's the last batter that Caden Trigg's going to face. As Jim McGuire comes out. He does not come out to chat. He comes out to get the baseball. So we'll have a Summit Concrete call to the bullpen. Tell you about the new pitcher we return on the VolState Sports Network.
We're all working in the cloud. But what really is the cloud? If you start pulling back the clouds themselves, you find out it's an infrastructure. Computer science is really computer engineering. Right now,
Middle Tennessee is quickly becoming a growing tech hub with several IT companies that are looking for skilled workers.
If you're pursuing the CIT program at VolState, you're preparing yourself to fill those positions.
Have you ever wondered what happens when you click buy it now? A whole series of transactions take place from the manufacturer to your front door.
That is logistics and supply chain management.
At VolState, we offer end-to-end supply chain courses.
Going into the future, our students need to understand these processes.
A lot of business is dependent upon getting a product on time.
Students here at VolState are able to leave here with that knowledge.
Because the supply chain
is counting on me.
Summit Concrete call to the bullpen. Trent Miller, 6'4", 235-pound freshman from Greenbrier, Tennessee, son of Bill and Treva Miller, out of the bullpen in relief of Caden Trigg. Miller on for his eighth appearance of the year, as seven out of the bullpen. 10 1/3 innings. He's got one save, struck out 16 batters. Had some issues with control as he's walked 17 and hit seven batters. He's going to come in with nobody out and one on here in the top of the fourth inning. Caden Trigg goes three innings, gives up four hits. Right now, only one run, but the runner on base is his responsibility. Walked two, struck out three. Trent's the older brother, or sorry, the younger brother. Presley and Kendall. as a nanny in Kingston Springs. Bill's dad, last time I saw him down in Roan State, was on crutches. He had a couple boots on both feet. I'm sure he's here. He might be out in left field. I don't see him here in the stands, but had a couple surgeries to fix some issues. There's a bunt laid down. Miller tries a backhand, and his throw goes down the right field line. Sacrifice bunt works, but Miller compounds after bobbling the ball, picks it up and throws wild down to first base. So runners now at second and third.
Now batting number 24, Matthew Varga.
Still nobody out. So give Amir Streeter a sack, but an E1 moves him to second. Sacrifice moves Santos to third, but the error moves Santos to second, but the error moves him to third. So it does not count as an at-bat for Amir Streeter. It'll count as a sacrifice hit. Now Matthew Vargas, who walked into second at the plate, first pitch misses. On two balls and no strikes. What do you think that line is up there on the far right of the Toyota of Gallatin scoreboard? Alex Qualls working the scoreboard from down in the dugout. There's a unknown character up there on the scoreboard. And the count goes three balls and no strikes. On deck, Jack Clark, the right fielder. That one catches the outside corner. So Miller threw a strike on the first pitch that he delivered to Streeter, laid down a bunt just to the right of Miller. He bobbled it, but came up, still thought he could get the runner at first. It was a close play, but the throw went down the right field line. There's ball four, and the bases are loaded.
Stepping to the plate, number 22, Jake
Barker. First error of the game for the Pioneers. Now has the bases loaded. Jack Clark stands in. Flew out to center field in the second. If he does it again, he's going to get an RBI. And there's a wild pitch. It's going to score a run. Dyersburg State leads 2-0. Almost another one. Swing and a miss. Clark figuring that Miller would put one right down Broadway, which he did not. It was a little bit outside. On the outside corner at the letters for a called strike. Couple walks in the inning and an error have resulted in a run. Swing and a miss as Miller comes back to get Clark on strikes. There's the first out of the inning. Back to the top of the lineup, Edward Mateo's 0 for 2. And Miller struggling to get in the groove here. That's a deep fly ball. Reggie Cooper's back. I'm not sure if the field will not hold that one. That goes over the Allie Cassidy brick and stone sign in right center field for a three-run home run off the bat of Edward Mateo. And they now lead 5-0. They led 5-0 in game one, and VolState ended up coming back. Kobe Benson steps to the plate. That is Mateo's third home run. There's the breaking pitch, gets in there for a called strike. That is Mateo's third home run. Ball, two strikes. Kobe Benson now, two balls and two strikes. Three runs in for Dyersburg as they bat here in the top of the fourth inning. Full Count Ministries, full count to the Eagles shortstop, who's 1 for 2. Fisted, looks like Molnar will be able to get over into the hole, make the catch as Benson got jammed on that one. Now two outs.
Now batting number 19. Enrique Alvarez, Jr.
First baseman Alvarez, Jr. stepping to the plate. He's 1 for 2. Actually, four runs in the inning. One charge to Caden Trigg. The other three... charge to Trent Miller as tennis ball comes over the dugout. A couple kids over here playing wall ball. Two oh pitch, fouled straight back. Trigg ends up with three innings, four hits, two runs that were earned, walk two, struck out three. Other three runs charged to Trent Miller. So he pitches to Alvarez Jr. with two outs, 3-1 count. Fly ball out to left field. Zimmerle back, and then he's got to come in and make a shoe top catch. The wind was knocking that one down, but he does. Ends the inning. There was one big hit in that inning. It was a three-run home run by Edward Mateo. Four runs. Three of those were earned. The one on the sacrifice who reached Streeter, not an earned run. One big error. No runners left on base. Ball State's going to have to come from behind again. They're down 5-0. You're listening to the Ball State Sports Network.
I took business management because I want to have my own business one day.
It was time for me to take that step and enroll in VolState.
When a student comes to VolState, they can leave here with knowledge that applies to all aspects of business.
Cybercrimes take place online, and companies need more well-trained workers to stop it.
VolState is training me to help combat cybercrimes in the future.
We're training them for those type of jobs that are out there. VolState CIT programs prepare students to earn industry standard certifications within the IT industry.
I choose VolState because the future needs me now. My story could be your story.
A degree in criminal justice can help you find the exciting career that you've been looking for. As a member of law enforcement, as a crime scene investigator, a teacher in a classroom, a detective working on cases, a lawyer or judge, or nearly any job where you get to put the bad guys away. Learn more at volstate.edu.
The bottom of the fourth inning, walked in the second. VolState down 5-0 as Jacob Sitton, pitching out there with the 5-run lead, delivers a strike to the Pioneer first baseman. Pink batting gloves for Connor Paul. Called strike. Down in the count 0-2. Five runs, five hits, no errors for Dyersburg. No runs, two hits, one error for VolState. Line drive softly hit to Kobe Benson at shortstop. Brings Christian Dunn to the plate. Struck out swinging in the second.
Christian Dunn.
Swings at this one and lifts one out to right center field. Back goes Streeter. Back goes Clark in right field, and that hits off the full count ministry sign. Looks like Clark ran out of room. Now, why do I have two right fielders? Where do I have? Oh, Clark is out in left field. That's what my problem is. Like Garcia was still there. Garcia, like he ran into the fence. That is a double, one out double by Christian Dunn. About 5 feet away from getting solo home run. Reggie's going to square the bunt, pull the bat back. Parker Patterson wants a check with the base umpire. Christian Moffitt, who says no, he did not go. Swing and a miss. Christian Dunn's third double of the year. He has four extra base hits in his seven hits this year. Three doubles and a home run. That's going to hit the elbow, I think, of Reggie Cooper, and he's going to
now batting number
hustle down to first base. Does not wear an elbow guard. Got hit twice in yesterday's game one. Now Brady Knepper steps into play. First hit batter of the game for Jacob Sitton. Two on for Knepper with one out. Breaking pitch called strike. sitting, looks back at second. There's another breaking pitch that Nepper looks at for strike two. Luis Maldonado, home plate umpire, doing some landscaping, housekeeping work there. His area of the home plate area. Nepper wasn't going to let another breaking pitch go by without taking a hack. Fouls that one down the third base line. Nepper grounded into a fielder's choice in the second. Swing and a foul tip into the mitt. Strike three. Now two outs here in the fourth.
Now batting, number 17, Walker Strange.
Second strike out of the game for Sitton, who came in. Tied for fourth in conference play. Strange ripped a single in the left field in his first plate appearance. Caleb Pika is second in the conference in strikeouts with 56. Breaking pitch down in the dirt. Strange able to hold up on that one. Austin Breedlove leads the conference with 81 strikeouts. 2-1 pitch to Walker is a little bit high. Goes 3-1. Logan Molnar standing on deck, the leadoff batter, hoping to get an at-bat here in the bottom of the fourth. Pioneers down 5-0. Almost a quick pitch there. Of a full count ministry's full count, runners will be off on the pitch. Christian Dunn from second and Reggie Cooper as time is called. Dyersburg State pitchers liking to get things rolling along. Get the sign, get set, and throw the pitch. Strange is said to have swung on the pitch. Throw down to first base by Patterson. Walker could not hold up on the breaking pitch, and he is down on strikes. Put out 2-3. Or out number three. No runs, one hit. The one out double by Christian Dunn. And two runners left on base. We are through four, scheduled for seven here in game two of the doubleheader, game three of the series. Ball State's got work to do to sweep the series. Down by five. Let's get to our Allie Cassidy Brick and Stone alumni spotlight. Today's alumni spotlight is Chaz Paul, P-A-L, also known as Charlie. Chaz, a nickname for Charlie. Played in 2012 through 2014 for Vol State and then moved on to USC Aiken, where former head coach of the Pioneers, Kenny Thomas, was coaching at the time. University of South Carolina at Aiken. He played there in 2015 and 2016. He is from Pompano Beach, Florida. He has a brick in the alumni brick patio, just like Ryan Darnell, our game one of the doubleheader alumni spotlight, and Hayden Trum from yesterday's game. 2014, he hit .415, had 53 hits, 16 doubles in only 39 games, but there were 10 games on the schedule that were not recorded, so there's a good chance that he had several more hits and more doubles. Batting average might have been a little lower than .414, honestly, but he was an all-conference player. At USC Aiken, he hit .336 and 393 and then 336. Played over 100 games for KT down there. If you'd like a brick for your grandson or your son that's in his second year here at VolState, send me an email to treesports@gmail.com, and I will get you hooked up with getting that going as Trent Miller's back out on the mound for the Pioneers. Chaz Paul, our Allie Cassidy Brick and Stone alumni spotlight today. We want to thank Randy West and Keith Green over at Allie Cassidy Brick. Popped up into center field, Reggie Cooper back, and now he's going to come in, and he's going to keep the hat on and make the catch for out number one. That was Parker Patterson who flew out to begin the fifth. Carlos Garcia over two stands in. Randy West, one of the owners over at Allie Cassidy, used to be my neighbor right across the street. His son and my son were best friends for about 5 years, from the time they were 5 till they were 10. They had to move to the other side of town. Got an all-brick house built in Brentwood, Tennessee. Beautiful house. Now all the kids are all grown up. Boys are about 32 years old. Called strike on that breaking pitch. My son's got 2 kids. Elliot's got 1. Maybe 1 on the way. Breaking pitch. Garcia had a late hack at that. Nepper fields and throws over to Paul. 2 quick outs here in the fifth. Keith Green is the division manager here at the Gallatin location, not too far away from the VolState campus. 2 outs, nobody on. Miller pitching to Jake Santos, misses just outside. Santos 0 for 1, walked and scored a run. No idea. Where did that miss? Two balls. I would have said that was right down Broadway. That one, I wouldn't say that about. That's just a bit too high. 3-0 after getting the first 2 outs. Dyersburg State with 1 in the second. And just for the fun of it, I'm going to hit you in the hands. 3-0 pitch. It almost looked like Santos was starting to swing at a 3-0 pitch, but that pitch just kept coming in and in and in on Santos, and he's going to get first base on a hit by pitch instead of the 4-pitch walk. That is the 8th hit by pitch thrown by Trent Miller this year. That leads the squad. Caden Trigg, who is the starting pitcher, 2nd on the squad with 6 coming into today's game, did not hit a batter. So a 2-out hit by pitch. Amir Streeter, who's 1 for 1 in a solo home run in the 2nd inning, stands in. He starts to bail out on that breaking pitch. He saw his buddy Jake Santos get hit, and he said, not on pitch 1. Santos takes off, breaking pitch, a called strike. Throw is yanked to the left. Christian Dunn, like he was asking for an interference call by Streeter. But a stolen base by Santos. A a stop by done on that slider in the dirt, sliding to his right. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Another wild one to the right of Dunn. Santos moves up to third. Second wild pitch of the game by Trent Miller. 2-2 pitch is high. Full count Ministries, full count to Amir Streeter. Two out walk puts runners at the corners. Matthew Vargas does not have an official plate appearance yet. He's walked twice, scored once. Streeter was the first batter that Miller faced when he came in relief of Caden Trigg. Streeter laid down a bunt, moved the runner over, throw over to first. He's back in time. But Miller bobbled the bunt that was laid down just to the right of the mound and threw wildly to first. Another throw over to first. Not sure if the sun is bothering Connor Paul at this point in time at quarter after 4 o'clock in the afternoon Central Time. Might be a consideration. Runner takes off. Breaking pitch lands inside. Streeter stands up on the stolen base. Two in scoring position with two outs. Two quick outs. Fly out and a ground out. And Miller hits Santos on a 3-0 pitch. And then has walked Streeter. Stolen base and wild pitches. Or wild pitch and stolen bases have moved the runners to third and second. Timeout called by Christian Dunn. It's his one. Is the catcher allowed only one per batter, just like the pitcher is allowed one disengagement? Swing and a miss on a high fastball. On deck, Jack Clark. Swing and a miss. Miller trying to get out of the jam here, and he's going to throw a full count Ministries, full count. The kids' camp is, I think, in first week, it might be in the second week of June, right after the Full Count Rhythm begin playing. Go to fullcountrhythm.com. Check out the kids' camp. Fouled off to the right side. It'll be held at Drake's Creek Park in Hendersonville, Tennessee. Ages 5 to 12. I think we had a couple hundred there last year. Great time. The Full Count Rhythm players handle the camp for the most part. Full count pitch to Matthew Vargas, and it's going to stay high, and the bases are loaded. Looks like Trent Miller is going to face at least one more batter. Coach Jim McGuire drives see if the young freshman can work out of the situation. Got the first two out. Hit batter and a walk and another walk loaded the bases. Jack Clark steps in. Miller just does not look comfortable. Not sure if it's the mound he doesn't like, the shoes he doesn't like. He's going to step off, and now he's going to ask for a medical visit, I guess. Miller is asking for Jim McGuire to come out. Now Jim McGuire is going to ask for Justin McKinney, who's down in the parking lot. They're going to just go ahead and take the baseball from Miller. He must have felt something in his elbow as he's coming off of problems from his senior year last year. He had surgery and pointing toward his elbow. So we'll have a Summit Concrete call to the bullpen. Bases loaded, two out and a 1-0 count. Not sure if that's Max Castle coming in. He might have been loosening down in the bullpen already. He will come out, but he'll get all the time that he needs to get prepared as he's coming in due to an injury. Harrison played in the Full Count Fall League this past fall. Parents Glenn and Elizabeth Castle from Clarksville, Tennessee, Clarksville Academy. He is ready to go. Hello to Grandmummy in Franklin, North Carolina, and Mimi in Cullowhee, North Carolina. Breaking pitch in there for a strike. Comes in with two outs. Big batter here, Jack Clark is 0 for 2 with a fly out and a strikeout. Time is called. I think we got a balk. Is it? Was it based on a time? Jim McGuire out to find out what the issue was. He's asking Luis Maldonado. I don't know which umpire called the balk. Was that the plate umpire? Plate umpire called the balk, which makes sense if that's who Jim McGuire's talking to. But Dyersburg State now leads 6-0. Castle rides one way inside. No hits in the inning, and one run has come in. That run charged to Trent Miller. Three balls and a strike to Jack Clark, the left fielder. Wild pitch, another run's going to come in. Clark's going to head down to first base. Runner's going to be at the corners. Dyersburg State with the touchdown, an extra point.
Edward Mateo.
Leadoff batter Edward Mateo, 1-for-3 with a 3-run home run. Steps in, swinging a miss or swinging a foul tip. Runner at first was taking off on the pitch. They have a couple stolen bases here in the inning. See if Christian Dunn just called a play that would involve him throwing the ball to second base. If Jack Clark takes off, he does not. Popped up to the left side. Logan Molnar out. In just in the outfield grass will make the catch for the third out. But two runs on no hits. No errors. Several wild pitches, though. Stolen bases. And two runners left on base. Dyersburg State leads 7-0. Headed to the bottom of the fifth. You're listening to the VolState Sports Network.
We're all working in the cloud. But what really is the cloud? If you start pulling back the clouds themselves, you find out it's an infrastructure. Computer science is really computer engineering. Right now,
Middle Tennessee is quickly becoming a growing tech hub with several IT companies that are looking for skilled workers.
If you're pursuing the CIT program at Ball State, you're preparing yourself to fill those positions.
Have you ever wondered what happens when you click buy it now? A whole series of transactions take place from the manufacturer to your front door.
That is logistics and supply chain management.
At VolState, we offer end-to-end supply chain courses.
Going into the future, our students need to understand these processes.
A lot of business is dependent upon getting a product on time.
Students here at VolState are able to leave here with that knowledge.
Because the supply chain
is counting on me.
Every day, all around the nation, people find themselves in need of a hero. Fire and emergency medical responders are those heroes we need. If you desire to make a difference in your community, visit VolState.edu to learn more.
Bottom of the fifth, we go. Top of the order for the Pioneers, Logan Molnar, Zach Zimmerle, Stephen Bell due up. Dyersburg now 7-0, 1 in the second, 4 in the fourth, 2 in the fifth. The lead 7-0. Jacob Sitton delivers a fastball right by Logan Molnar's nose. Ground ball to third, bobbled, and Molnar is going to reach. Going to see if that was Jake Santos still down at third base after he got hit by the pitch. That is Santos. He's going to get the E5. Molnar now 0-for-3. First error of the game for the Eagles. Zimmerle steps in. He's 0-for-2. Zim 2-for-6 in yesterday's game one of the series. Looking for his first hit of the doubleheader today. Blocked by Patterson on the breaking pitch. Fly ball out to right field sends Garcia back. He's still going back and makes the over-the-shoulder catch for out number one. Zimmerle's hit a couple fly balls deep in this game, but 0 for 3. Stephen Bell 0 for 1. He got hit by a pitch his last at-bat. Breaking pitch catches the outside corner. Fouled off to the left side. Chattanooga State putting it on the Lady Pioneers in game two after winning 11-4. There's a ground ball up the middle. Could be two. Benson Gloves steps on the base and throws on to first for a 6-3 double play to end the inning. So the error does not come back to bother Dyersburg. As Sitton faces the minimum in the fifth. Was one error in the inning. Nobody left on base. Through five, we're scheduled for seven. Take a break. You're listening to the VolState Sports Network.
I took business management because I want to have my own business one day.
It was time for me to take that step and enroll in VolState.
When a student comes to VolState, they can leave here with knowledge that applies to all aspects of business.
Cybercrimes take place online, and companies need more well-trained workers to stop it.
VolState is training me to help combat cybercrimes in the future.
We're training them for those type of jobs that are out there. VolState CIT programs prepare students to earn industry standard certifications within the IT industry.
I choose VolState because the future needs me now. My story could be your story.
A degree in criminal justice can help you find the exciting career that you've been looking for. As a member of law enforcement, as a crime scene investigator, a teacher in a classroom, a detective working on cases, a lawyer or judge, or nearly any job where you get to put the bad guys away. Learn more at volstate.edu.
Tim Reese back at VolState, where the Pioneers behind 7-0 here in the second game of the doubleheader. Got the victory in come-from-behind fashion in game one, if you weren't with us. 7-6, scored 4 in the fifth inning and 3 in the sixth. And held on in the top of the seventh. Noah Eatman came on to get the save. There were two runners on when he came in. Jack McLaurie got his third win of the year. Max Castle delivers the first pitch outside the zone to Kobe Benson. Benson 1-for-3. Castle came on in relief of Trent Miller, who left with right arm discomfort. That's my quote, nobody else's. Castle walked the first batter he saw and one pitch away from walking Kobe Benson here to lead off the sixth. Got Edward Mateo to pop out to Molnar at shortstop. That's in there for a called strike. Pioneers on the road to Walter State on Friday. Ball four a little high. And the first runner reaches. Second walk of the game for Castle. By my count, that is 7 for Pioneer pitching today. My statistics are unofficial. I Got Trent Miller at 1 2/3 innings, only one hit. It was a big fly, though. 5 runs, 4 earned as Enrique Alvarez Jr. steps in, and he swings and misses at the first pitch he sees. 3 walks for Miller, 1 hit by pitch, and 1 strikeout. Throw over to first, Benson back. Benson has 1 stolen base in this ball game. Slow roller, that'll go foul. Benson now with 11 stolen bases. Two in yesterday's game and one in each of these games in a doubleheader, and he's going to take off there, but he's going to have to come back. Enrique Alvarez Jr. fouls that one over to the on-deck circle. Parker Patterson reached up there with that throwing hand. That's always dangerous. Get a finger jammed there, and it's not going to be fun for a catcher. 0-2 pitch again from Castle. In the dirt. Dunn blocks that one up the first baseline. Kobe Benson stays put at first. Caden Trigg started 3 innings, 4 hits, 2 runs. Trent Miller on in relief in the 4th inning. Now Max Castle, the third pitcher for the Pioneers. Looking for a doodat double play ground ball. Benson goes, pitches outside, throw down to second base. Into center field, Benson gets up and he just heads on over to third. A stolen base and an error on the throw by Christian Dunn. Second error of the ball game by Ball State, and they'll play the infield in. And Alvarez Jr. gets plunked. Putting runners at first and third. First hit batter of the game by Max Castle. Parker Patterson steps in. He's 1 for 3. Singled in the first, lined out to the second baseman in the third, and flew out to center in the 5th. Dunn blocks another one back there. Castle's all over the place right now. Walking a hit batter here. Looking similar to the 5th inning where Dyersburg scored 2. There's a ground ball to short. Could be 2. Molnar to 2nd. On to 1st base. They will not get Patterson. He runs pretty well for a catcher. RBI fielder's choice.
Up bat
is Dyersburg State, an 8-0 lead. Carlos Garcia stands in. Breaking pitch in there for a called strike. Lots of sunshine here today in Middle Tennessee. There are some clouds up there. If we had a meteorologist major up here, we'd go ahead and ask him. Braxton Alexander, he comes from the country. He probably knows. Cumulus clouds right there, Braxton? Not cumulus. He says with confidence, not cumulus. It's the only kind of cloud I know. I don't know what other clouds there are. One ball, two strikes. Maybe. Talking a good game, Nimbus. Nimbus Aurelius. Sounds like a skin disease. Swing and a miss. Down goes Garcia on the breaking pitch. Now you're just saying stuff that sounds like it might come from the Bible. Making up names. Jake Santos, 0-for-1, backs away from a breaking pitch. He saw a 3-0 pitch. I think it was a breaking pitch. It hit him in the hand. It was a fastball. That doesn't come up in geology class, does it? Or Spanish? Como se dice cloud in Espanol, por favor? How do you say cloud in Spanish? We probably have some folks listening in that probably know the answer to that. You could get on your Spanish-English dictionary that you have on your phone, I'm sure. Say, how do you say cloud in Spanish? Think J.C. Menendez knows that answer? Well, if he knows Spanish, then he knows it. He can conversate? I didn't say he's fluent. I said, can he conversate? Can he talk? Can he talk it? Three balls and a strike. Ball four. Second walk of the inning. Third free pass. It's now three walks for Max Castle.
Number 13, Amir Freeder.
Grandson Eli played a soccer game earlier this morning and bled into the afternoon. My wife sent some videos already. Streeter looks at a breaking pitch right at that front knee that catches the inside corner. Streeter 1-for-1. Sacrifice on which he reached and walked and scored in the fifth. He scored three runs in this ball game. Nice stop by Christian Dunn. Net breaker in the dirt. Fastball over the glove of Christian Dunn. Wild pitch to the backstop. Patterson moves to third. Jake Santos to second. Two outs. This is where your infielders start getting a little bit stale. Breaking pitch catches that inside corner again. It's like cloud in Spanish is nube. N-U-B-E. Another one. Max Castle just burying him right there in that front knee for a called strike, and he gets out of further damage. Two strikeouts in the inning. Again, Dyersburg State scores without the benefit of a hit. One run. There was one error. And ended up, I think, costing the Pioneers that run. No hits. Two runners left on base. 8-0. Dyersburg State leads. Headed to the bottom of the sixth. You're listening to the Vol State Sports Network.
I took business management because I want to have my own business one day.
It was time for me to take that step and enroll in VolState.
When a student comes to VolState, they can leave here with knowledge that applies to all aspects of business.
Cybercrimes take place online, and companies need more well-trained workers to stop it.
VolState is training me to help combat cybercrimes in the future.
We're training them for those type of jobs that are out there. VolState CIT programs prepare students to earn industry standard certifications within the IT industry.
I choose VolState because the future needs me now. My story could be your story.
A degree in criminal justice can help you find the exciting career that you've been looking for. As a member of law enforcement, as a crime scene investigator, a teacher in a classroom, a detective working on cases, a lawyer or judge, or nearly any job where you get to put the bad guys away. Learn more at volstate.edu.
Jacob sitting back out on the mound for Dyersburg State. Looking like he wants to go the full 6, 7. Got to go at least 5, and he's done that. Thedrick Harris is going to get a pinch hit at bat here for Cannon Lewis. Redshirt freshman out of John T. Overton High School. Famous alumni from Overton. I named Mookie Betts, but yesterday's game winner, Caleb Pika. Swing and a miss. Thedrick comes out of the dugout swinging a stick. Thedrick Harris Jr. And going to get a foul ball on that one. Didn't get the bat handle out of the way. Three pitches, Thedrick Harris down on strikes. Sitting, rolling along, only giving up 3 hits. It's his 4th strikeout of the ballgame. Cameroon Hodges getting an AB. And I'm sorry, that's not Cam Hodges. That's Carson Sanders. Thinking, what's he doing pinch hitting for a first baseman? Not, it's Carson Sanders, who is a first baseman. Hits a ground ball slowly to Benson. Gloves throws on the run over to Alvarez Jr., 1 pitch, and Carson Sanders is down. So 4 pitches in, and Sitton is a pitch away from getting out of the inning. Carson Sanders, he don't like to stand up there long either. If it's in there, he's going to take a hack. Christian Dunn also swings at the first pitch, fouls that one into the dugout. He's not worried about a 5-pitch inning or a 4-pitch inning. Dunn 1-for-2, drove one to the full count ministry sign out in right center field. Able to hold it up on that breaking pitch. I would expect that Carson Sanders will go to first base in the 7th. Christian Dunn with a hit, Reggie Cooper with a hit, and Walker Strange, the only 3 hits of the game for VolState. And there's a hit, but it's a hit by pitch. I assume Sitton was on the squad this past fall with Christian Dunn. He reaches base twice in the ball game. Second hit by a pitch by Sitton. Now 7 on the year. Brings Reed Mashinsky to the plate. He's going to get a pinch hit appearance from Bradenton, Florida. Pinch hitting for Reggie Cooper. He swings at the first pitch. These guys coming out of the dugout. It's not like they're wanting to apparently read pitchers. If they see a pitch over that they like, they're going to take a hack. Reed Mashinsky, common spelling of Mashinsky. Nearly takes one in the lid there. Reed's first at-bat in a good while. Been injured most of the year. Goes to the right side. Count goes 1-2 to Reed. Another foul ball. Young goes 2-2. Mashinsky will probably go out to center field in the top of the seventh as well. Drew Plummer standing on deck if the inning continues. And it's going to continue. Oh, I thought that got a piece of Mashinsky. Apparently not. Either that or he wants to hit. Of a full count ministries, full count. As the runner at first will take off with the pitch, not being held on. There's a sharp ground ball to second. Vargas is going to have to go to first base, and he will for out number three. Mashinsky down on the ground out. No runs, no hits, no errors, one runner left on base. We are through six, scheduled for seven. VolState going to have a big inning in the bottom of the seventh. The Lady Pioneers dropped the doubleheader to Chat State. 11-4 and 12-3 as that game has concluded across campus. Chat State comes into Gallatin and takes 3 out of 4. From the Lady Pioneers. Here, Dyersburg State trying to take game three of the series. As we have a new pitcher on the mound, Carter Waltz, freshman from Springfield, Tennessee. Springfield High School, 5'10, 155 pound general studies major, the son of Richard and Melanie Waltz. Younger brother to Noah and grandson of Pops and Nana in Hendersonville, Granny in Coopertown, and Granddaddy and Graham in Springfield. Waltz on for his fourth appearance of the year. He's thrown 3 innings, giving up 1 hit, 1 run, 5 walks, 2 strikeouts as a 3.00 ERA. Comes in for Max Castle. It goes an inning and a third. Does not give up a hit. Does give up a run. Walks 3, strikes out 2. Hits 1 batter. Waltz was probably wearing, is he wearing number 41 out there? Reed Mashinsky is in center field. Cam Hodges now out in right field. First pitch from Waltz to Vargas. Outside the zone for 1. Drew Webster in left. So we have all new outfield. And Webster's going to get a chance out there as he's going to catch one on one hop off the bat of Vargas, who had walked in his three previous plate appearances. I'm seeing Jack Clark on my roster. I'm not seeing Jake Clark. So unless you've just named him like I've named the Eagles the Tigers yesterday, his family might appreciate you calling him Jack. I've got Jack. Carter Waltz looking for a ground ball and gets a called strike on the outside corner. Clark is 0 for 2 with a walk. So Drew Webster in left, Reed Mashinsky in center, and Cam Hodges in right field. Waltz now three balls and a strike to the number nine hitter. And ball four. A leadoff single and a walk. The first two reach here for
number 26, Edward Mateo.
Dyersburg. Edward Mateo, switch hitter, moving around to the right side. He's 1 for 4, three-run home run. Sam Folk's going to come out of the VolState dugout, the pitching coach. Have a chat with the young left-hander. He, like Trigg, had a late start to his collegiate career because of some arm issues. Caden Trigg started the game. Brent Miller came on, and then Max Castle, Carter Waltz. Is the fourth pitcher on for Ball State. Mimi's still listening in down in Gadsden, Alabama, rooting on the Pioneers. Breaking pitch. This is high. Wind still blowing from center field over to the right field line. That hasn't changed all day. Waltz now three balls and no strikes to the leadoff batter. First appearance of the year was a couple weeks ago against Cumberland University JV. Four pitch walk to the leadoff batter. Now loads the bases.
Kobe Benson
also a switch hitter. Steps in. Waltz then had one inning of work against BCA and an inning of work against Columbia State. Gave up a hit and a run. Benson swings at the first pitch, fouls it off to the right side. Benson 1 for 3. Singled in the third, walked and scored in the sixth. That breaking pitch missed somewhere. Not sure where. Maybe down. Carter needs that pitch called a strike. Nobody out. Bases are loaded. Need a ground ball back to Waltz. Now 3-1, nowhere to put Benson. Swing and a miss. Full count ministries, full count to Kobe Benson. From Boca Raton, Florida. And line drive right back to Waltz. He makes the catch. They got the runner at first base off. And the throw to first base. A triple. No, did they get the out at third too? He called him out at third. I didn't think they got that out. That is a triple play, folks. Holy smokes. That's the old 1-5-3 triple play. I thought the runner got back at third. Waltz throws the pitch, looks down, finds the line drive in his glove, immediately throws over to third base. Walker Strange stepping on third to force out Vargas. And Mateo was way off at first base. And the throw over to first base for a who in the world we got that sponsors a triple play. We'll have to come up with it. 1-2-3 outs. Ends the seventh. The first one that's happened in my time as a broadcaster. A triple play, 1-5-3. And Benson was the first out of that. We're heading to the bottom of the seventh. Pioneers need 8 to stay in the ball game.
We're all working in the cloud. But what really is the cloud? If you start pulling back the clouds themselves, you find out it's an infrastructure. Computer science is really computer engineering. Right now,
Middle Tennessee is quickly becoming a growing tech hub with several IT companies that are looking for skilled workers.
If you're pursuing the CIT program at Ball State, you're preparing yourself to fill those positions.
Have you ever wondered what happens when you click buy it now? A whole series of transactions take place from the manufacturer to your front door.
That is logistics and supply chain management.
At VolState, we offer end-to-end supply chain courses.
Going into the future, our students need to understand these processes.
A lot of business is dependent upon getting a product on time.
Students here at VolState are able to leave here with that knowledge.
Because the supply chain
is counting on me.
Every day, all around the nation, people find themselves in need of a hero. Fire and emergency medical responders are those heroes we need. If you desire to make a difference in your community, visit volstate.edu to learn more.
Well, triple play to end the top of the seventh. And I missed Drew Plummer, who'd come into the game at second base in the top of that inning. But he was not involved in that triple play. He's going to get an at-bat right here. And look at a called strike from Jacob Sitton. Going for a complete game. There's a base hit into left field. Sharply hit ground ball to the left of Santos at third. Leadoff single for Drew Plummer. Walker Strange steps to the plate. First pitch to Strange in there for a called strike. Swing and a miss. lot of changes here for VolState. Drew Plummer, redshirt freshman, on at first base with the single. Strange slices one into the aluminum stands to the right side. Sitting steps off the rubber. That's his one and only disengagement he's allowed for this batter. That's dropped into center field. Walker Strange picks up his second hit. We're going to have another pinch hitter here.
Now batting number 16, Gage Hoover.
Gage Hoover is going to get a at bat for Logan Molnar. Freshman from Stewart's Creek High School. Smyrna. Molnar finishes this game 0 for 3. Finishes 0 for the doubleheader. Hoover gets his first at-bat of the series. Drew Webster standing on deck. Right-hander getting loose down in the Dyersburg pen just in case Sitton runs into big trouble here in the bottom of the seventh. It's the final inning of the doubleheader. Breaking pitch lands in the inside corner. That's unless VolState scores eight, puts a snowman up on the board in the bottom of the seventh, then we'd go to the eighth. Hoover with a healthy cut right there comes up empty. Gage, the son of Mike and Angie Hoover. Look for a big hit right here. Just missed down low. 6 foot, 200 pound freshman. Got a younger brother, Michael. Grandparents both sets in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. And it will slice, turn, twist, and go foul down into the right field corner. A new right fielder out there, Tommy Melvin in right field. Now we have a full count, Ministries full count. Not sure how long Melvin's been out there, but maybe he just got out there for the bottom of the seventh. 3-2 foul ball straight back. Ball four loads the bases. Good eye right there by Gage Hoover.
Drew Webster.
First walk of the game by Sitton. Had to check that a couple times. See if Webster goes to swing at the first pitch. He does not. It lands inside. Webster, a sophomore from Christ Presbyterian Academy in Nashville, Tennessee. Ground ball to the right side. That will sneak through into right field. One run's going to score. That breaks the shutout. And an RBI single by Webster.
Up to bat, number 35. Cam Hodges
steps in. Been hot lately. Third hit of the inning. comes in to score. Everybody moves up 90 feet. Hodges, a smoky bear from Sevier County, lays off the breaking pitch by Sitton. Got his mom here in town, grandparents swing and a miss on a high fastball. Jessica and Chris Roberts in from Kodak, Tennessee. There's a breaking pitch that catches the knees, and he's down in the count, one ball, two strikes. Pop and Brandy from Granger County, Tennessee, I believe are in town. Hello to his dad, Michael, stepmother, Stephanie. Went 3-for-4 in game two, I believe, of the doubleheader against Cumberland. That was the doubleheader that I missed. We don't have any tape for it, but it's showing up in the box score. Just got a piece of that one. Apparently got a little piece of Parker Patterson behind the plate. The Framework Athletics first run of the game scored by Drew Plummer. Framework Athletics located at 104B Jessica Lauren Court. It's where the Pioneers go to train when they can't get on the field here at Pioneer Field. Hodges with a ground ball to the left side, and it sneaks through. So RBI singles by a couple of the full count D group members has brought the Pioneers back to 8-2. Still nobody out. Tyler Brown, the interim head coach, is letting Jacob sit and ride. Cedric Harris back up to the plate. He came in as a pinch hitter for our DH, Cannon Lewis. Looks at ball one. How about Fetty going ahead and getting a hold of one right here and clearing the bases, including himself. Make this interesting here in the bottom of the seventh. Swing and a miss, tied him up. Two-one pitch to Harris, called strike. If I mistakenly call Cedric Lewis, apologize. He's hitting for Cannon Lewis, fouls that one straight back. Harris, 6'2", 215-pound redshirt freshman, son of Cedric Harris Sr. in Shreveport, Louisiana. And his mother, Clarissa Harris, in Nashville. Has a brother, Jalen, and a grandmother in Minden, Louisiana. He drives one out to right center field. Streeter over, and he can't get it. It drops to the ground, and they're going to go 90 feet again as Cedric Harris gets an RBI single. And Vol State down 8-3. Back to back to back hits brought to you by Hit After Hit. Go to Hit After Hit online. And out of the dugout comes Tyler Brown, and that might finally do it for Jacob Sitton, who at this point has not gotten an out in the seventh. He makes the call to the bullpen as five hits by Pioneer hitters. See, all our Jersey Mike's subs in the game except for Walker Strange. So Drew Plummer began the inning with a single to left field. Walker Strange singled to center. Gage Hoover walked, and then back-to-back-to-back singles, RBI variety by Drew Webster, Cam Hodges, and Cedric Harris. Now bring Carson Sanders to the plate with a new pitcher out on the mound. Right-hander Dean McCullough from down in Houston High School. His brother Jake pitched here a couple of years ago for the Pioneers. Dean, 6'3", 190-pounder from Collierville, Tennessee. He's going to come into a bases-loaded, nobody-out situation. It's his eighth appearance of the year. He does have one save. Let's see, this is actually not sure if they're going to count. I don't think you count this as a save situation down by five, but the tying run is in the on-deck circle, so I might have to check that. He does have one save. He's got 9 1/3 innings, 13 hits, 9 runs, only 5 earned. At a 4.82 ERAs. Walked 6, struck out 10, and has plunked one batter. He comes on to face Carson Sanders with bases loaded, 3 runs already in. Not sure if Jake is here in attendance. I'm not sure if Jake's still playing or not. Right-hander out of Houston High School. So Jacob Sitton goes 6-plus innings. Got 8 hits. Carson Sanders again swings at the first pitch. Aggressive hitter. Just missed with that fastball. Nice pitch there by McCullough to get Sanders to think about it. One walk, 4 strikeouts, a couple hit batters. Sitting in line still for the win, but getting tense here for Dyersburg State as they saw a come-from-behind victory by the Pioneers in Game 1. And Tyler Brown, the interim head coach, is over there sweating bullets right now, even though his team's up by 5. And a drive down the left field line, but it's going to go well wide of the bullpen into the parking lot. On deck is Christian Dunn. Swing and a miss on a breaking pitch. Sanders down on strikes. First out of the inning. Dunn was hit by a pitch in the 6th, doubled in the 4th, but was stranded there at 2nd. 1-for-2. See if Christian can get a big hit here in the 7th against his former team. Looks at a breaking pitch for a called strike. Swing and a miss. I'm sure these two fellas faced each other in high school. Collierville versus Houston. There's a ground ball to third base. Santos throws it in the dirt at second base. Everybody's going to be safe. And another run scores on the error. 8-4. As Dunn is recorded as a fielder's choice. Harris gets to second base on the errant throw by Santos. That's his second error of the game. Webster scores. Now Mashinsky swings and misses. Strike 2 at the knees. Shinsky grounded out to second. He's the ninth batter to come to the plate. Fouls one off to the right side. Stays alive. Four runs in the inning on five hits. That's a wild pitch. Getting over the glove of Parker Patterson. Another run's going to come in, and other runners move up. Now 8-5. Drew Plummer, who led off the inning, is standing on deck. Swing and a miss, and that's out number two. Kahlo strikes out two of the three that he's faced so far. Now VolState down to their last out. Drew Plummer, the tying run at the plate. Fastball missed, I'm guessing down. That's a ground ball up the middle. Should do it. Benson, high throw to Alvarez, but good thing he's 6'4". And he makes the grab. And Dyersburg State comes back to snag the third game of the series. But Pioneers make it close with five in the bottom of the seventh. And this is a final. 8-5, Dyersburg State wins. They move to 6-9 in conference play. 16-17 overall. VolState falls to 13-18. And 3-11 in conference play. The Pioneers do win 2 out of 3. Jacob Sitton gets the victory. He moves to 6-4 on the season. Caden Trigg will take the loss. See what he goes to. He falls to 0-2 on the season. I'll have to do some checking to see if Dean McCullough ends up getting a save on that. Typically, you come into a game, if it's more than three innings or three-run lead in the last inning, you don't normally get a save, but there might be a different ruling right there. But 8 runs, 6 hits, 2 errors. Unofficially on the Toyota Gallatin scoreboard for Dyersburg State. 5 runs, 8 hits, and a couple errors for VolState as the fifth week of the conference has concluded. Just 4 more weeks. In conference play, Walter State away, back home in 2 weeks against Southwest Tennessee, and then away again to Jackson State, and the final series of the year is Cleveland State. Let's see who we have for our Toyota of Gallatin player of the game. A couple hits by Walker Strange in the game. No RBIs, though. We had RBIs in the last. There was only 3 RBIs in the game. Drew Webster, Cam Hodges, and Thedrick Harris. So I'm going to have to go across the aisle with Jacob Sitton, who goes six innings, does give up eight hits, and all five of those runs. But he pitched a great first six innings. Jacob Sitton will be our Toyota of Gallatin player of the game. So he gets his sixth win in 11 decisions. Sorry, 10 decisions. He got a lot of decisions. Six innings gives him now 48 for the year. And we'll get to our Toyota of Gallatin, our Full Count Ministries verse of the game. Mimi had a couple of them early on. She had John 3:16 in Psalm 27. Of course, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave us one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Psalm 27, 20, verse 7, is some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. A little different verse way than I've memorized it, but our Full Count Ministries verses of the game is going to be found in Mark chapter 16 again as the last chapter. This is verses 15 and 16. He said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. Those are the words of Jesus after he had rose from the grave, giving a mandate to all those who believe to go give the good news to others. I try to do that for you folks. Read the last chapter of each of the four gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, to read about an amazing event that happened in human history. We celebrate that tomorrow all around the world, called Easter Sunday. The only time that a person has risen from the grave himself. That'll do it from Pioneer Park, or Pioneer Field, here at the Tim Garrett Baseball Complex. Game that took 2 hours and 24 minutes. Dyersburg State ran out to an 8-0 lead, but had to hold on again with a 5-run seventh inning by the Pioneers, who had the tying run at the plate, but fell to the Eagles of Dyersburg State 8-5. For Athletic Director Bobby Hudson and Head Coach Jim McGuire, this is Tim Reese saying, thank God that I'm healthy enough to come back and broadcast yesterday and today. Appreciate those of you that prayed for me and my family in our sickness time. We will talk to you again real soon. Probably Friday is the next scheduled opportunity. We'll be in Morristown, Tennessee, the home of the Senators. I'll talk to you right here on this same channel, the VolState Sports Network on YouTube. Good night. God bless you, and happy Easter, everybody.